Hello everyone and welcome back to the pharmacology practicals. So in today's video we shall cover the experiment common laboratory techniques, that is blood withdrawal, serum and plasma separation, anesthetics and the euthanasia, which are supposed to be followed for the animal experimentation. Okay, so these are the commonly utilized techniques when you are carrying out some experiments. You may have to withdraw the blood from the animal for some of the biochemical investigations. If you have to carry out, you may have to withdraw the blood. So in today's video we are going to cover the different methods of blood withdrawal from the animals. After that we are going to cover the serum and plasma separation. Okay, so for certain studies you may have to separate the serum or the plasma for the evaluation. So these techniques we are going to cover, and the third one is the anesthetics which are supposed to be used for the animals. Okay, that is whenever any surgical procedures are supposed to be carried out, appropriate anesthesia is supposed to be given. Okay, so which are those anesthetics? And which are the acceptable methods or acceptable routes by which you can administer these anesthetics to the different species. And also we are going to cover the euthanasia, that is the painless killing of the animal. Supposing if during any experiment you may have to sacrifice the animal, so just because they are animals you just can't kill them by any particular method. Okay, there are appropriate acceptable methods depending upon the different species which are specified, and you need to follow those methods, and they should be sacrificing the animals in a painless manner. Okay, that is with minimum of pain and minimum of distress to the animal. So coming to the first technique, that is the blood withdrawal. So before going into the actual methods of blood withdrawal, let us see what are the different principles of blood collection. Okay, so firstly the method, it should be described and approved by the institution's animal ethical committee, IAC, which is established in an institute. So they should approve the appropriate method for blood collection. So also the procedure, it should be least painful and stressful to the animal. Also the person who is carrying out these particular techniques of blood collection, they should have appropriate training for the blood collection. Okay, so an untrained person should not go for blood collection, otherwise they can harm the animal. So utmost care has to be taken as to minimize the pain and the injuries to the animal while collecting the blood samples from the animals. Now the needle size is also specified depending upon the animal. So most commonly used animals for the studies are mice and rat. So for mice, 23 to 25 gauge needle can be given and up to 1 ml blood can be collected because it's a small animal, whereas for rat, 19 to 21 gauge needle can be used and blood samples of up to 10 to 15 ml can also be collected. Now let us see what are the permissible volumes of blood which can be collected from the different species. So as we have discussed earlier, that most commonly used animals are the mice and the rat. So we'll focus on this. So the quantity and the frequency of blood sampling, this will depend upon the circulating blood volume of the animal. So as I've told you, mouse, it is a smaller animal, so it has a small volume of blood, that is 80 ml per kg, and for rats it is 70 ml per kg. This is the volume of blood which is present. So accordingly the amount of or the volume of blood which you can collect from these two animals, it depends upon the body weight. So if the mouse weighing in between 20 to 25 grams, you can withdraw 0.11 to 0.14 ml of blood. In case if the mouse is weighing 30 to 35 grams, then 0.17 to 0.21 ml of blood can be collected. Whereas in case of 40 to 45 grams, 0.22 to 0.28 ml of blood can be collected. In case of rats, the volume is little bit higher. The rat weighing in between 100 to 150 grams, 0.6 to 0.91 ml of volume can be collected. Rats weighing in between 200 to 250 grams, 1.1 to 1.5 ml of blood can be collected. And the rats weighing in between 300 to 350, 1.7 to 2.1 ml of blood can be collected at a time. Okay. Now coming to the actual techniques of blood sample collection. So there are five different methods by which the blood sample can be collected. First one is saphenous vein blood collection. Second one is tail vein blood collection. Third one is dorsal pedal vein blood sample collection. Fourth one is the orbital sinus blood sample collection. And the fifth one is the cardiac puncture. Okay. So the names also imply the site, or they also indicate the vein from which the blood is collected. So coming to the first method, that is saphenous vein blood collection. So here actually while collecting the blood, anesthesia might not be required. It is not necessary to anesthetize the rat. Okay. So blood is it is collected from the saphenous vein, as the name implies. Okay. So this particular saphenous vein, it runs dorsally and laterally over the tarsal joint. Okay, that is the hind limb of the animal. Okay, the tarsal joint which is there. So that particular vein runs over this tarsal joint. Okay, so first this particular site is supposed to be shaved. That is, the hair should be removed. Rat should be restrained so that it should not move during the collection of the blood. So this will minimize the stress. So animal should not be subjected to stress, or the duration of restraint, okay, that should also be minimized as much as possible while collecting the blood sample. Okay, so while collecting the blood, the hind limb of the animal must be immobilized. Okay, so you should extend the hind limb of the animals. So if the animal, supposing if the animal is difficult to handle, then it may be necessary to anesthetize the animal. A mild anesthesia can be given to the animal. So needle, it is inserted in this particular vein which is exposed. A small puncture is given, okay, and the blood sample is collected. And care should be taken that multiple punctures should not be done. It should not exceed more than 3 attempts at a time. So if it goes fails, then you should not go for further attempts. Okay, otherwise it will damage the tissues in the hind limb of that particular animal. Okay, now after collection of the blood, you can just press the area gently with the finger so that the blood clots and the blood stops oozing out from this puncture, a small puncture which is made, and the animal can be returned back to the cage. So this is the location of the lateral saphenous vein. So this is the hind limb of the animal, and this vein, it runs dorsally and laterally sideways towards this particular tarsal joint. This is the tarsal joint. Okay, so it is exposed. You have to shave this area so that the vein will be exposed and you should collect the blood sample. Then the next technique is tail vein blood collection. So as the name implies, the blood is collected from the tail vein. Okay, so this is quite commonly utilized techniques, applicable for all strains, and it is quick and simple to perform. Okay, now for this purpose, sometimes you may have to warm the animal slightly to dilate the blood vessels, to expose the blood vessels. So sometimes it can be stressful to the animal and it may deviate from the results of your experiment. So you should be careful while performing this particular experiment, okay, or this particular technique. Now wash the tail with the dilute hibiscus to expose the blood vein. So in order to make the blood vessel visible, you may have to apply this dilute hibiscus to the tail of the animal, so it will expose the veins. Okay, now number of samples which you are collecting, this should be minimized. Okay, also sufficient time should be given for the recovery of the tail. So you just can't go on collecting the blood from the tail multiply. You need to give time for that animal to recover, okay, because you are making small punctures on the tail, right? So you are, to a certain extent, it may damage the tail. So as far as possible, minimize the number of collections and also give sufficient time for the recovery. So here in the tail, lateral vein is exposed, and while collecting, you should start collecting from the one-third along the tip of the tail. Okay, you should not start from the base of the tail. Okay, so you should start from the tip of the tail and then you should move towards the base of the tail. In case if you are collecting multiple samples, okay, you should not collect the blood from the base side of the tail and then move towards the tip. Okay, you should go vice versa. Distal end should be utilized first and then you should move towards the proximal end of the tail. Now reason for this is because you're puncturing the vein, it may result in the clot formation or inflammation. So this will reduce the amount of blood which is flowing in the distal regions. So that is the reason you should start with the distal portions and then go towards the proximal end of the tail. Okay, so here also the animal is restrained, if you can see, and the tail vein, lateral tail vein, it is exposed and the blood sample is collected. So from the tip end you should start, and then for the next sample collection you should go towards the base of the tail. And the next method is dorsal pedal vein blood sample collection. So here the rat needs to be restrained and the hind foot around the ankle it is held, and the medial dorsal pedal vein is located and the blood sample is collected. Okay, now you need to first clean this foot with the absolute alcohol and then the vein is punctured with the help of a fine needle. So blood will start dropping out, so this is collected in a capillary tube. Okay, so this is the one, dorsal hind limb. Okay, so hind limb is used for this. So with the help of a fine needle, a puncture is given over here. So as the blood oozes out, it is collected in the capillary tube. Next method is orbital sinus blood sample collection. So here the animal needs to be anesthetized. Generally rat is used for this particular technique. Here specialized capillary tubes are utilized, that is standard heparinized microhematocrit capillary tubes are required for the blood collection. Okay, so first of all the animal is anesthetized. Okay, and as the name implies, orbital sinus, that is the blood is withdrawn from the eye region. Okay, so the animal, after the anesthesia, the animal, it is held by the loose skin of the neck. Okay, with the help of the thumb and the middle finger, you need to hold the animal, and the tip of the capillary tube, it is just placed in the medial canthus of the eye, which is just under the nictitating membrane of the animal. Okay, so once you place the capillary under this medial canthus, a short thrust is given. Okay, that is a small push is given, slight push is given. It should be given very, very carefully, as to taking care not to damage the eyeball. Okay, so it should be appropriate. The capillary, first of all, should be appropriately placed just beneath the medial canthus, and a small thrust is given. Okay, so that the capillary, the sinus will be, the membrane of the sinus will be punctured, and the blood will start entering the capillary tube. Okay, so you should be very careful not to injure the eyeball of the animal. So this is a very skillful technique and should be carried out by a trained person. An untrained person should not go for this method, otherwise the eye of the animal may get damaged. Okay, so after you have done with the blood withdrawal, just give a slight pressure on the eyeball so that the excessive bleeding should not take place. So this is a picture depicting the retroorbital sinus. This is the one from which actually the blood is collected. So this is a medial canthus into which the blood, the capillary is placed. Okay, and a small thrust is given so that this capillary is punctured and the blood oozes out from this retroorbital sinus. Then the next method is cardiac puncture. Okay, so as the name implies, cardiac puncture, meaning here the blood is collected from the heart. Now this particular method of collection of blood, it is actually recommended at the terminal stage of the study. Okay, and a single large volume of blood can be collected from the animal. Okay, so after this, the animal needs to be sacrificed. Okay, so here the blood is collected from the heart, okay, that is from the ventricles, using a needle with a 23 gauge. Okay, now here the animal needs to be deeply anesthetized. So you should ensure that while complete collection of the blood, the animal should be under the anesthesia, should not gain back the consciousness. So for that matter, you can apply a paper towel which is soaked in the anesthetic and just keep it near the nose of the animal, near the rat's nose, so that the rat should not gain the consciousness. Okay, so after the anesthesia is given, the rat is placed on its back. Okay, so animal will go unconscious. You should place the rat on its back. Then place the finger on the lowest rib without applying the pressure. Just place it to locate the lowest rib of the animal. The heart, it is located roughly 1 centimeter above this particular point. That is the lowest rib of the animal, slightly towards the right hand side. So this is the location of the heart. So now take a syringe, hold it at 45 degrees angle and insert the needle in between the two ribs, the lower lips, so that a drop of blood will ooze out. So this indicates that your syringe or your needle is in the heart. So without moving the syringe, just pull the plunger to collect the blood in the syringe. So once the syringe is full, you can disconnect the needle, okay, keeping the needle in place, which is inserted into the heart. Empty this syringe into the tube and you can reattach this syringe for more collection of more blood. So likewise, you can collect 5 to 10 ml of blood from 150 to 200 grams of the rat. But after the collection of blood, immediately you need to euthanize the animal post blood collection. You should not allow the animal to gain back the consciousness. Okay, so otherwise it will be highly painful and it is not advisable, actually. As I've told you earlier, that this is a terminal blood sample collection techniques, after which the animal needs to be sacrificed by utilizing appropriate method. So this is the picture showing the collection of the blood. So you can see here the needle is held at 45 degrees angle and the blood is being collected in the syringe. So this to do with the blood sample collection. Then the next technique is the serum and plasma separation. So coming to the first technique, that is separation of the serum. So 10 ml of the whole blood sample, it is collected in serum separator tube, which is also known as tiger top tube. Okay, so this, once the blood is collected, it is allowed to clot for 1 hour at room temperature. After which it is centrifuged for 10 minutes at approximately 1000 grams, and after this, aliquot of 210 microliters of serum, it is collected in cryo vials and immediately freezed at minus 80 degrees freezer. Then the next technique is separation of plasma. So again, here the blood will be collected in the purple top EDTA tubes and centrifuge for 2000 RPM at 4 degrees centigrade for 20 minutes. After which, by using a clean pipette, 1 ml of the plasma, it is stored in 1.5 ml Eppendorf tubes, which is labeled appropriately with a tracking number and it is labeled as plasma, and it is immediately freeze dried at minus 80 degrees in the freezer. Then the next important techniques in the experimentation which is carried out in animals is the anesthetics and the euthanasia, which is used for this animal studies. Okay, now generally, if any procedure, it is painful in nature, then it is necessary to conduct such kind of procedures under appropriate anesthesia, which are recommended for a particular type of species. So depending upon the species, you can make an appropriate choice in between the different anesthetics. Okay, and you should ensure that during entire procedure, which is supposed to be painful, you need to maintain the animal under the anesthesia for full duration of the experiment, which is considered to be painful. If at all, while carrying out these procedures, if the investigator feels that the experiment needs to be abandoned, then the animal needs to be sacrificed. Okay, then in case if the animal is supposed to be sacrificed during any stage, if the person feels or the investigator feels that animal needs to be sacrificed, or if the experimental requirement is such that the animals have to be sacrificed at the end of the studies, so for that purpose also approved methods of euthanasia is supposed to be followed. So this particular euthanasia we have also discussed under the CPCSEA guidelines. Okay, so over there also we have discussed that while sacrificing the animals, you need to do it in a humane manner so that the animal should not feel any pain or distress while it is being killed. Okay, so there are specified techniques which are listed according to the species which have to be followed. And after the animal is sacrificed, you need to maintain the appropriate data of this particular procedures also. Now coming to the first one, that is anesthesia. Okay, so wherever possible, if the procedures which are carried out in the animals, if they are painful in nature, you need to carry out these procedures under anesthesia. Okay, so just because they are animals, okay, causing pain or inducing pain in them is not advisable. You should be taking utmost care of the animals. Okay, while handling also and while carrying out certain procedures also, wherever applicable, you need to use the anesthesia. You may have to use some additional drugs also, like sedatives or analgesics to reduce the pain, and anesthetics may be used. Okay, so wherever pain or distress is involved in whichever experiments. So sometimes these agents may even affect certain other systems also. They are supposed to act on the CNS, but sometimes cardiovascular system or respiratory system, thermoregulatory systems may also get affected. So as per the need of the experiment, it should not even alter the parameters which are being studied during that experiment. So that care also you should take. So you need to appropriately select the anesthetic depending upon the animal, depending upon the procedure, depending upon the duration of experiment. Okay, also before anesthetizing the animal, you need to prepare these animals by fasting overnight. Also, if required, pre-anesthetic medications have to be given to you know, block some parasympathetic stimulation or cardiopulmonary system, or to reduce the salivary secretions which may be caused by these anesthetics. So in order to reduce all these, you can use certain medications as pre-anesthetic, something which is given before the anesthesia is given. So atropine is generally used as an anticholinergic drug to reduce all these effects. Okay, then depending upon the nature of the experiment, you may have to select whether you have to give local anesthetic or a general anesthetic. Okay, local anesthesia means it will anesthetize only a specific area. General anesthesia means the entire animal will be anesthetized, will be unconscious. So depending upon the surgical procedure, you may have to select whether local or general anesthesia is supposed to be used. Okay, now local anesthetics, they usually block the nerve supply to a limited area, so this can be used for minor and rapid procedures. Okay, so here again expertise is required. A trained person is required to identify a particular nerve and inject the local anesthetic around that particular nerve, so that wherever it is supplying, that area will get anesthetized. So there are several techniques: infiltration techniques, nerve block technique, epidural or spinal anesthesia, which are done by the experts. Okay. Apart from this, general anesthetics may also have to be given, wherein entire animal's CNS is depressed over here. So the animal will be unconscious. So these are generally given as inhalants or sometimes intravenous or intramuscular injections of, say, for example, barbiturates may also be given to anesthetize these particular animals. Okay. Now, while administering a general anesthetic to an animal, you should take care of selecting appropriate anesthetic depending upon the species. Also, the side effects such as excessive salivation, convulsions, excitement, disorientation, all these should be prevented and controlled by using pre-anesthetic medications. Okay, atropine is generally given. Also, the veterinary care should be available during entire procedure. Okay. And even in the post-operative periods also, appropriate veterinary care should be provided to the animals. Okay. Now, this is a table showing the different general anesthetics which are used, okay, in the laboratory animals. So, as per the species, you can select the appropriate anesthetic in a particular dose. Okay, in the given route. Okay, so your routes are also specified. IM is intramuscular, IV is intravenous, IP is intraperitoneal, SC is subcutaneous. Okay, and before administering these anesthetics, you may have to administer atropine, because it will help in reducing the secretions, the salivary secretions or bronchial secretions. Even the heart cardiovascular complications will also minimize by the atropine when it is given before administering the anesthetics to the animals. Okay. Then next is the euthanasia. So euthanasia is painless killing. So in case of any requirement of your experiment, or maybe if the animal, it is some irreparable changes have taken place, so in that case you may have to sacrifice the animal. So this also should be performed as per the rules or the guidelines which are given. Okay, the euthanasia, that is painless killing, when you sacrifice the animal, it should be quick and painless. It should not induce any pain, or it should be carried out in an atmosphere which is free from fear or anxiety. It should not induce the anxiety in that animal. Also, in certain techniques, you may have to impose initial depressive action on the CNS, central nervous system, in the animals to reduce the pain in that animal, which may be caused due to this particular procedure. So sometimes certain additional drugs may have to be used. Now, the method of euthanasia, it will depend upon the nature of the study and the species of animal which is supposed to be sacrificed. So usually, while whatever method you are selecting, depending upon the species, you should keep in mind some points. That is, the death which is caused, it should be without causing any anxiety, pain or distress, with minimum time lag phase. That is, once you start with the procedure, it should as far as possible immediately result in the death of the animal. There should not be any time lag, okay, or should not induce any anxiety, pain or distress in that animal. Again, it should have minimum physiological or psychological disturbances. It should be compatible with the study also. It should not alter the parameters which are being studied. Also, it should have minimum emotional effects on the person who is carrying out the procedure. Location in which you are carrying out this procedure also should be separate from the animal rooms and free from any kind of environmental contaminants. And for larger animals, sometimes tranquilizers may have to be administered before the euthanasia procedure is being carried out in these particular animals. So these are some few points which you should keep in mind while euthanasia is utilized in any animal in the terminal stage. So this is a table which is showing the different techniques of euthanasia which are applicable to different species. So according to the species, you may have to select a particular method. Now here certain letters are given, NR, this indicates not recommended. So here in case of all the animals, electrocution is not acceptable. Okay, exsanguination, that is death which is caused due to excessive bleeding. Okay. It is also acceptable in certain species, whereas in dogs and monkeys it is not acceptable. Okay. Then decapitation, that is isolation of the head from the or the brain from the spinal cord. This is also not acceptable in all the species. Okay. Cervical dislocation. Okay, also not applicable for all. Okay, so likewise you need to select an appropriate method, whether it is a physical method, inhalation of certain gases like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, okay, carbon dioxide with chloroform or halothane, or overdose of certain drugs like barbiturates, chloralhydrate, ketamine or sodium pentothal and so on. Okay, so wherever applicable, you should select an appropriate method depending upon the appropriate species by a given route. So here routes of administration are also specified. Okay. Whereas these methods are not acceptable in any of the animals. Okay. Stunning, head blow, inhalation of certain nitrogen, argon flushing. Okay, so all these administration of all these type of drugs, such methods are not acceptable in any of the species of animal. They should not be practiced. Okay, so these are some of the procedures which are utilized for painless killing of the animals. Okay, so these are all the commonly used laboratory techniques which we have seen, that is techniques of blood collection. Then we have seen the plasma in the serum separation and anesthesia and euthanasia which can be used in the animals. So these are the references. Thank you.